Hello guys, welcome to all of you. Let us solve some bio-inorganic questions which may come in the CSIR NET exams. Okay, the fourth question is the metal ion involved in the electron transfer reaction and the metal ion involved in the catalyzing hydrolysis reactions respectively are. Okay, there are four options: iron, zinc, magnesium iron, cobalt and molybdenum, or calcium and copper. Okay, as we know that in the electron transfer reaction the electron transfer reactions are brought about by the iron sulfur protein. Okay, in the iron sulfur protein, the active site is the iron atom. Okay, therefore the reactions which are catalyzed by the iron sulfur proteins are called the electron transfer reaction. Okay, in this electron transfer reaction, the iron atom is responsible. Okay, therefore the iron atom will be present in the iron sulfur protein which carry the electron transfer reaction. Okay, the second metal which hydrolyze the protein is called the zinc, because the zinc ion is present in the carboxypeptidase A enzyme. This carboxypeptidase A enzyme brings about the hydrolysis of the peptide bond. Okay, therefore the first metal which is involved in the electron transfer reaction is the iron atom, and the second metal atom which is involved in the hydrolysis reaction is called the zinc atom. Therefore the correct option will be the first. Okay, the next question is the matching the column 1 with the column 2. Here is the, in the column 1 here are the proteins, and in the column 2 here are the metals. Which metals relate with these proteins? Okay, the first protein is the cytochrome. As we know that in the cytochromes the heme group is present. Okay, in this heme group the iron atom is present in the active site. Okay, therefore in the cytochrome the active site is occupied by the iron atom. Therefore this will match with the iron atom. Okay, the second protein is the calmodulin. As you know that the calmodulin protein is the calcium binding protein, and it binds the calcium. Okay, therefore it will match with the calcium atom. The third protein is the chlorophyll. As we know that in the active site of chlorophyll, magnesium atom is present. Therefore chlorophyll which match with the magnesium. Okay, the fourth protein is the alcohol dehydrogenase. As we know that the alcohol dehydrogenase contain the zinc atom in the active site. Okay, therefore this will match with the zinc atom. Okay, now the next question, now there is the next question which is also for matching, which is also for matching. Okay, here are the column 1 and here are the column 2. Okay, in the column 1 are the metal atoms. There are 3 metal atoms, and in the column 2 the related proteins are present. Okay, the first protein is the phosphotransferase enzyme. Okay, the second protein is the peroxidase enzyme. The third protein is the carboxypeptidase A, and the fourth protein is the hemocyanin, and fifth protein is the nitrogenase enzyme. Okay, and here are the related metal atom. Okay, as we know that the zinc atom is present in mainly two enzymes called the carboxypeptidase A and carbonic anhydrase. Here is the carboxypeptidase A. Therefore the zinc ion will present in the carboxypeptidase A. Okay, the copper atom, as we know that, is present in the hemocyanin protein, which carry the iron. Okay, therefore the copper atom is present in the hemocyanin protein. This hemocyanin protein acts as the oxygen carrier. Okay, and we know that in the nitrogenous enzyme, the iron, the molybdenum atom is present. Here is only the iron atom, and this iron atom will be present in the peroxidase enzyme. Okay, therefore the correct match will be this. Okay, now we will solve the other question. The next question is the changes which occur when dioxygen binds with the hemerythrin. Okay, that is, the question is the changes which occur when dioxygen binds with hemerythrin protein R. Okay, here are the four options. The option A is the one iron atom is oxidized. Okay, the option B is both the iron atoms are oxidized. Okay, the option C is the oxygen binds with one iron atom only and is also hydrogen bonded. Okay, the option D is dioxygen binds with both the iron atom and is also hydrogen bonded. Okay, there are some combinations are, the option one is the correct option, the option B or B and C. The second option is the B and D. The third option is the A and D, and the fourth option is the A and C. Okay, therefore the which option will be the correct? As we know that when oxygen binds with hemerythrin, the only one iron atom binds with the oxygen atom, and this bonded oxygen atom is also hydrogen bonded. Okay, let us draw the structure of the hemerythrin. As we know that in the hemerythrin there are two iron atoms are present. The first iron atom is bonded with 3 histidine amino acid, whereas the second iron atom is bonded with only 2 histidine amino acids, and there are the carboxylate group of aspartic acid which bridges between the two iron atoms, and here is the carboxylate group of glutamic acid which also bridges between two iron atoms, and between two iron atoms a hydroxide ion makes a bridge. Okay, this is the hemirythrin. This is the structure of the deoxyhemirythrin. Okay, as we know that when oxygen binds with this hemirythrin, the iron atom, here is the oxidation state of each iron atom is +2. Okay, when oxygen binds, the iron atom in which the three histidine amino acids are bonded, here is the iron atom with this two histidine amino acids are bonded, and there are the carboxylate group which bridges the aspartic acid, and this is the carboxylate group of the glutamic acid. Okay, and this is the OH group. Okay, as you know that when oxygen binds, both the iron atom gets oxidized. That is, one iron atom is +3 state and the second iron atom is also in the +3 state. The bonded oxygen binds with only one iron atom like this. Okay, and this oxygen atom is also hydrogen bonded. Okay, therefore we know that when oxygen binds, both iron atom gets oxidized and bonded oxygen is also hydrogen bonded. Okay, the correct option will be the one iron atom is oxidized. This is the wrong option. Okay, because both the iron atoms are oxidized. The second option is both the iron atoms are oxidized. This is the correct option. And we know that the option C is the oxygen binds with one iron atom only and is also hydrogen bonded. Okay, this is the correct option. Okay, therefore the correct option are the B and C. Therefore the correct option here mentioned is the option first. That is the correct option is the B and C. Okay, this is all about for today. So please subscribe my channel and ring the bell icon. Thank you.